Let's move on to the next presentation, number three. So I'll invite Indira Klimatavisyen to come and talk to us about her really incredible project on smart emergency call and response solutions for hospitals. Indra, thanks for joining us today.
So thank you very much. I'm Indra Klimatavisyen, coordinating the implementation of EcoQuip project here at Santaros Klinikos, and at the same time, I'm head of innovation and technology transfer division here in the hospital. So next slide, please. Talking about the hospital, so we are the largest we are one of the largest hospitals in Lithuania, founded by Vilnius University and the Ministry of Healthcare in early 1980s. Our mission is to provide advanced and integrated healthcare for patients and develop and implement biomedical innovations. We are big, we are more than 6,000 and a half of employees, and we are tertiary level healthcare organization active in medical research and also serving as training center. And also we can say that we are the leaders in health information and communication technologies and medical informatics. So next, please. So starting the EcoQuip project, we discussed a lot about the problem, and our problem selected was identified by our anesthesiology and intensive care department. So despite the high quality of professional care provided here and professionals working in the hospital, a life-threatening emergencies acquire, and we found out that we need to require rapid mobilization of and assistance of colleagues. So we needed the better management of these occurring emergency situations, which occurred in, let's say, situations such as complicated tracheal intubation, cardiac arrest, or severe bleeding, because the existing call and response system was not effective. It caused a lot of stress to our employees, staff, which trying to call for assistance, and the staff trying to respond to them. It also could increase the risk of severe complications to patients as well. We was in such situation also because of very difficult layout of the hospital. As the hospital is big, it is operating in 19 hospital buildings in a huge territory of more than 170 square meters. The current situation sometimes resulted that more specialists than needed reacted to the emergency situation, or sometimes we had also faced the situations when the assistance comes too late. So we definitely had to solve this, and therefore, next slide, please. We came up with that we need to install a smart emergency call and response solution that improves the management of life-threatening emergencies, leading to a better patient outcomes and staff experience. Next. So discussing the requirements for the system, we were guided by the expert of the EcoQuip Plus team. We found out that we need a 24/7 alert pathway working where the most appropriate medical specialist can arrive at the location of emergency. We also need the feedback mechanism on the call in order to reduce the stress for the staff calling for the help and manage the responses. And also we need data collection and analysis models working, because we are the learning organization, and we need to register these events. We want to analyze them and to learn for the future how we can improve the processes and better manage them. Next slide. So after discussing the needs, we drafted, prepared the statement of demand. We have happy that and communicated it, and we are happy that we attracted the support of other hospitals, other five hospitals, which also had the same problems. And it validated that our need was that and made us confident that this is the situation we have to solve. Yes, and this joint statement of demand was published and promoted and in preparation of for open market consultations and helped us a lot. Next. So then after joint statement of demand publishing, we ended the open market consultations phase. And actually, I have to say that it was extremely rare in Lithuania at the time due to prevailing control culture of public procurement. We were more used to apply the formal communication with the suppliers and the market. And so it was really a new format, a new approach to hospital as well, applied for the first time. So we were very careful to ensure adherence to public procurement regulations when entering and implementing this open market consultation. Next. So we developed market communication documents to communicate our unmet need effectively to the market. Prepared outcome-based requirements and published it as a market-sounding prospectus and PIN in national and international platforms of public procurement tenders. So it was, and what we found out that it was not only new for us, it was also new to Lithuanian market. And it was not only we who were more used to formal presentation of market communication. It was, yes, it was really new to the suppliers as well. Yes, this market was launched in June 2021. It was accompanied by the questionnaire where we tried to gather feedback, and we also had market consultation event and bilateral meetings and the feedback questionnaire again. Next slide, please. After open market consultation, I want to look into the results and responses we received. So we are happy to receive 12 responses from the companies representing six countries. And it was also a good representation of SMEs. So the market confirmed that our solution was possible within the timeframe of a project to implement. We also received multiple ideas and different ideas, even from the view we imagined how solution could be how solved, the problem could be solved, and we're happy to receive that. So the solutions were unknown. Some of them were known to the project team. And we found out that suppliers were keen to have more detailed technical specifications. So of course, it's not surprising because the culture of public procurement is more formal in Lithuania. So they were more comfortable with detailed technical specifications. And we had to be creative and have to think how we should balance this need for innovation and the detailness, for technical detailness they requested to us. So we decided to draft the hybrid specification, detailing outcomes and functional requirements. Yes, to emphasize this vital to ensure compatibility with the internal IT systems. And also from open market consultation, we identified that really in the team, we need more IT competences, and we need to make changes in the team. Yes, to broaden the composition of the team. So the market engagement process provided to be a very important and useful and eye-opening step in preparation for the tendering process to the team, to the organization. And it demonstrated the value of active communication and openness with suppliers and benefits to provide advance notice to the market to allow it and to provide time to prepare for delivering the solution. And it was also important in building confidence in our team and validating the requirements and potential solutions. So working with the market engagement process gave us a perspective of how more informal and more proactive approach can benefit the procurement process. And we already applied this approach in other new projects. As example is like modernization of laboratory infrastructure. So we learned this lesson thanks to EcoQuip Plus project. Next slide, please. So after open market consultation, we entered the pro-innovation procurement phase. And actually it took time to us to reflect on the findings of the consultation and to translate them into procurement approach. So as I mentioned, we had to balance the need for technical guidelines and leave enough space for innovation. So we decided, so it was difficult to decide the tools, the procurement method we and the procedure we should proceed with. To ensure and to get the best solution to manage this crucial and critical clinical service provision. We concluded that further discussions will be needed with the suppliers, so between suppliers and internal stakeholders. Yes, that we need to make sure that the solution will meet our requirements. And therefore, we decided to select the competitive dialogue procedure, even though it takes much longer than other procedures in time. So it is the first time when Santaros Klinikos adopt competitive dialogue. It's also one of the first time in Lithuania when competitive dialogue is used for the purpose to enable innovation, because most of the time it is used for the complicated procurement, but not related to the innovation, innovative solutions. Next, please.
Thank you very much, Indra. I'm just going to jump in to say where you're 3 minutes over time. So if I could ask you to start to wrap up. Thank you so much.
Okay. Yes. So we, as I already mentioned, we agreed to include both functional and non-functional requirements. We balanced award criteria and we tried to remove the barriers for SMEs to participate in the tender, applying very light pre-qualification criteria and less demanding financial guarantees and insurances, avoiding it. Yes, please, next slide. The tender of Smart Emergency Call and Response Solution was launched in the November 2023 on local and European tender portals. And we are following all the steps of competitive dialogue. Currently, the tender is in process, still in process, and we are looking forward to receive the bids to be submitted until mid-January. So as we follow this process, we reasonably confident that we will receive the solutions, and we expect to. We are looking forward to. Next, please. So this process, it was incredibly learning experience for our organization and the team. what I want to share with you that it was the it required organizational change, and the changes requires time, and also this new approach not only time consuming this change, but also very important in the situations where financial decisions are required is support from both staff and senior management. So also that mapping all stakeholders and involvement of them, all the stakeholders from the beginning is very critical to success. We face staff turnover, and yes, it affects the process definitely and can result in delays. So it's important to manage that, and it's very important when you do the things for the first time, the external expertise. So we are happy that we had this EcoQuick Plus project assistance and external expertise we could learn from, and which assisted us in this process. So thank you very much. And the final slide, next slide. So yes, innovation procurement we are in, we currently run is made for the first time for our organization, and it's really very challenging because in Lithuania as well, the guidelines and methodological information for on how to run and how to handle procurement of innovation were launched only in January 2023. However, now we have a confidence that we can proceed with that and we'll definitely do innovative procurement later on. And Lithuania has very ambitious goals that innovative procurement would be like 20% of all procurement by 2030. So now we can see that thanks to EcoQuick project, we can add up to achieve these national goals we have. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Indra, and really fantastic goals that you've set as a result of this project. That's really impressive, a lot to learn from.